Hey everyone, Nina here from NB and NS, and happy Thursday. Today I'm going to be talking about Facebook Insights. So I, as a marketer, love data, and I have to tell you that when I was in school and when I started out my career, numbers were not my favorite thing in the world. I am a writer. I like to write. I'm creative. I like the marketing process, and when it came to numbers, not my deal. But as I got into digital marketing, I really found that data makes a huge difference in how your marketing performs and how you understand what's working and what's not working. So now I am a data nerd. I absolutely love data. I love that all of these social media platforms provide us data and information about how our marketing is doing and how our content is doing. And data drives everything that Neil and I do. We are always consuming our data probably a little more than we need to, but we love it because data tells a story and it tells us what's working and what's not working. So I wanted to talk about Facebook Insights because I know that a lot of people like me in the beginning are intimidated by the numbers. They're intimidated by data. When you click into Facebook Insights, there's a lot of information in there. There are a lot of tabs. There are a lot of things that you can look at. So I kind of wanted to talk about, you know, what are the things that actually matter and that you should be looking at in your Facebook Insights, and maybe some of the things that you don't necessarily need to worry about or look at on a less day-to-day basis. So we do have a course, it's called the Facebook Formula for Direct Sales Success. Enrollment is not open right now, but we have a lesson. So if you're a student of ours, make sure you check out that lesson. We review Facebook Insights in depth. We talk about what every single section means and what you should be looking at to improve your marketing. So if you're a part of that, make sure you check that out. But today, I'm just gonna be giving an overview of Facebook Insights, like I said, to kind of help you make sure that you understand what you're doing well, you're understanding your goals and how you can reach them by looking at the data that Facebook provides you. So I am working on getting a software where I can screen share, but I can't do it at the moment. So I have Facebook Insights open just to make sure I don't lose my place as I go through this. So as I go through this, if you have any questions at all, please feel free to ask them. I have it open on my screen over here and on my phone. Facebook is wonky sometimes. So I want to make sure that I get your questions. Also, if you're watching this on the replay, I do always go back and check questions. So if you're watching this and you have some questions, please make sure to ask. All right. So when you go into your admin dashboard, and so this is one of the benefits that we talk about when you have a Facebook business page, is you get access to Facebook Insights. So how you access that is you go to your admin board and you'll see a tab called Insights. So what you'll do is you go ahead and click on that. Now, I like to tell people that Facebook likes to frighten you, and they give you this dashboard as soon as you log in, and you'll see all of these graphs. You'll see arrows going up, arrows going down, green, red, and all of this information. And it can be really scary and intimidating. And I actually don't recommend you look at that every day because, for instance, I'm looking at ours right now. Most of it looks green. Our reach is up. We're running some advertising, so that always helps. But when I log in the morning, it'll be like red. You're down on likes. You're down on page views. Well, obviously, Facebook, I just got up. So don't freak me out. So I don't always like to look at that because it just gives you a snapshot of the day, and it's not necessarily reflective of how you're doing overall. So, but the first place that I like to go is I don't look at that part, and I click on over to posts. It's the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th menu item down on the left. And when you click into posts, you'll see there's a graph. It has the days. It has a graph that says times. And then it has all of your posts that you've published below that. So the first thing that I like to look at, and I do this when I'm planning my content for the week, and I've noticed Facebook has been tricky and changed something on me this week, and I'll talk about that. So the first thing I do is when I'm planning my content. So let's say I go to Monday, and when you hover over Monday, you'll see the graph with the times change. And you'll see a little line in dark blue, and it will tell you this is when your fans are online. And people always ask me, hey, when is the best time to post on Facebook? Well, the best time to post on Facebook is when your audience is on Facebook, and this is where you go to look to see when your audience is on Facebook so you can post then. So when I'm planning my content, I go here, and Lisa, it won't go live for you. The insights won't. Let me know what you're having trouble with there. So what I do is I go in here, and let's say on Monday, I know I wanna do a couple posts. So I'll hover over on the Monday, and it will give me that dark line, and it'll tell me what times of day that my audience are online. Now, the tricky thing that I noticed Facebook did is I used to go in here and plan my content for the week. I would go through each day and see, you know, which days have the most people online. It has little numbers above the days, and that tells you which days people are online there. And then when you hover it over it, like I said, it'll tell you what time. So the tricky thing that they changed is it used to pretty much stay consistent through the week. I've noticed now I'm looking at it and it is changing daily. So I went in and I do this every week so I can kind of get a good idea of a bigger picture, and I write them down. I go in and write down the times that are best on every day of the week, and then I go back and look at it throughout the week. And like I said, it used to stay the same. I've been going back this week and it's changing every day. So I went in and scheduled all of my content, and then I went and looked and the times were different. So you do have to be flexible and look at that. Jessica, yes. So this only applies to a business page. This is one of the benefits that you get with a business page, is knowing this information for insights. So you don't get insights at all on a personal page. So this is why you want a business account. Lisa, the reason maybe you're not seeing it is maybe did you recently set up your page, or do you have like a low number of fans? So sometimes Facebook won't give you insights until you have had a page for a little while or you hit a certain number of fans. So that may be the reason it's not going live for you. And Jessica, yeah, this is only for a business page. So that's really why you want a business page, is so you can have access to all of this information, because otherwise you don't get any of that information on your personal page. Okay, so I will look at every day and I'll hover over, see which days of the week people are online the most, and then I will look at what times they're on the most. So I'm posting during those times. So an example is I was working with a client and they were posting Monday through Friday. And we went in and we looked at their insights and we found that actually most of their audience were on during the weekends. And so we shifted when we were posting in order to post while their audience is online. So this is really important, because we all know we have that Facebook algorithm working against us, right? And so we want to do everything we can to make sure that our content is getting into the newsfeed of our clients. So this is one way that you could combat that, is at least try to see when people are online. Now, if you don't have a business page yet, or if you, you know, are just using your personal page, which you should have a business page, something I tell people is think about the lives of your clients and think about when they're online. And I'm finding for us that most of our audience, they're on first thing in the morning when they're getting their kids ready for school, and then they're on in the evenings after they've put their kids to bed, because we market mostly to moms and we market to women. And so those are the times that they're on. So you just wanna think about your customer, think about their lives, and think about when they are on Facebook. So if you don't have access to insights, but insights are incredibly powerful and you really wanna look at that, okay? So the next thing, and it's still in the post section, that I like to look at are all of the posts published. So you can see on your page, it lists all of your posts that you've ever published. They're in chronological order backwards, so the most recent to the top to the oldest. And what you can do is you can go in and look at these posts and see what kind of reach you're getting, what kind of engagement that you're getting. Hey, Kyle. And you can sort by all of these. So you can go in and sort by date. You can go in and decide, you know what, I want to look at how much reach I got on a certain post, or I want to look at posts that had the most engagement or the most comments or the most shares. So you can go in and look at the type of posts that are getting the things that you want. Now, what I want you to think about when you're doing this is, first, I want you to look at overall what kind of posts perform best with your audience. And look at that post and think about, why do you think that post performed well? And you want to look at several things. So is it quote posts are performing really well? Then you want to think about how you can use more of those. Is it video that's performing well? Or is a certain product that you are highlighting that's performing well? So you want to look at that. And then, but you also want to have your goals in mind. So you may have different goals. And for us, we have several different goals. And so sometimes it may be to get people to buy a product, or sometimes it's just to get people to engage and interact. And sometimes it's maybe to get them to watch a video. And so you want to look at those different things, having your goals in mind as to how that content is performing. So just keep that in mind as you're looking at that content, but you do want to look at that content to see what content is performing or what topics are performing, and do more of that, okay? So you can also, at the top of that menu, you can click on post types, and it will tell you, it'll give you a little graph of how, you know, just text or video or photos are performing. And so that's it with that section that I wanted to go over. So posts, the post section is my favorite section to look at because it gives me valuable information about when my audience is online and what kind of content is performing best and what it is driving people to the goals of what I want them to do to achieve in my business. So the next section that is my favorite section is the people section, and it's the second to last in the left-hand menu. And the reason that I like this section is because we really talk about how knowing your ideal client is really valuable in your business, is that you need to know who you're talking to, what their problems are, what their struggles are, what kind of things and messages resonate with them. So I like looking at this to, one, make sure that our fan base is the correct person that we're talking to. It will tell you a percentage of, oh, Jessica, it won't play. So the video, Facebook's not playing the live maybe? I'm not sure what may be going on. You might want to try to refresh, but if I'm telling you that, you're probably not seeing it. Hopefully it'll play afterwards then. Sorry about that. Facebook likes to be wonky, and it's been making a bunch of updates this week, so I think that might have something to do with it. Okay, so in this section, it will tell you the percentage of people who are women fans versus men. It will give you age ranges of your audience and percentages of your audience that are in certain age ranges. It will tell you where in the world your fans are. It will tell you what city they are and what language they speak. So this is all really great, valuable information just to understand your audience a little bit better. Now, something that I talk about in our course, the Facebook Formula for Direct Sales Success, is looking at this information can really help you when you are targeting your Facebook ads. So you can look and say, you know, I have a great presence in Phoenix. You know, our company is based in Phoenix, but I want to grow in these other markets. So I can look at the demographics. It stops and plays. And so, you know, I don't know. I've heard that Facebook has been having issues this week with live, so I'm so sorry about that. And hopefully, if you watch it during the replay, I will make sure to answer your questions. So if you don't get to ask your questions during the live because of whatever issues Facebook is having, then I will make sure to get to those. I apologize. Facebook's been so wonky this week. So I like to look at that information to help me guide with my Facebook ad. So again, you need to know your ideal client. We have an entire lesson on that in our course, and then look at this information for your demographic information. Now, the two other tabs that I really love in this section are people reached and people engaged. So people reached, reach is how many people see your content, and then people engaged is people that engage with your content. So comment, like, share, watch videos, things like that. So the people reached will tell you the number of people who your post was served to in the last 28 days. And the reason that I like this is it will show you if there's like a disproportionate amount of people in certain demographics that are seeing more of your content than others. So for example, let's look. So there is a disproportionate amount of people that are 25 to 34 that we're reaching than our fans. So we're reaching more people in the 25 to 34 age range than our fans. So we're doing a better job, I guess, of reaching those people in that age group. So what I discern from that is, what can I do better to engage the other age groups? Is our content not resonating with them? Am I not online at the times that that age group are online? So different things like that. The other thing that you wanna look at are people engaged. And so this will tell you, out of the percentage of your demographic, how many of those are actually engaging with your content. And so things that I look at for this is that our content may be resonating really well and therefore overperforming with a certain demographic, but is not resonating and not doing as well with another demographic. And again, you want to know your ideal client to know, okay, I'm doing a really good job of engaging and interacting with my ideal client, so I'm not worried about those other age groups. Or I had a client who had two ideal clients. One was a millennial mom and the other were senior citizens. And they were doing a really, really great job of getting the senior citizen ideal clients to interact with their content, but not the millennial moms. And so we looked at their content and we made a shift to make sure that our content was talking about kid-friendly meals and how to go to the grocery store with kids. They were an agriculture-based company. And different things that would appeal to the millennial moms. And then we even integrated things because we know we had the senior citizen audience and things to do with your grandchildren or ways to plant a garden with your grandchildren. So we kind of integrated ways that we could reach that other demographic and make sure that we were bringing them in the fold and engaging with them a little bit more. So that's the reason that I really love the people section, is it helps me with Facebook ads. It tells me if I'm reaching my ideal client and if they're engaging with our content. So those are all really important things to look for. Now, the other two things that I like to look at are our likes and reach tabs. Now, I don't spend a ton of time in here because you can drive yourself insane because it's going to change every day. You're going to have peaks and valleys. That's the nature of marketing. That's the nature of Facebook. So I don't want you to get very stressed out when you look at this section. So what I look for is I want to make sure I'm on an upward curve and we're growing. That's important. So that's the first thing that I'm looking at. The other thing that I'm looking at is times that we lose people. So there is a graph that will show you when you have people unlike your page. And so if I, it's expected to get a couple at a time. But if I see that we are losing, maybe like 10 people unliked the page, or there's a week that people are unliking it, I will go back and look at what kind of things I was posting on or around those days that maybe turned people off and caused them to unlike us. You know, maybe it was the content, maybe we were posting too often, maybe we were during a launch, so we were doing a lot of sales type of content. So those are the different things that you want to look at there. Again, I don't spend a lot of time in here. I want to make sure that we're growing, and I don't see anything funky when it comes to losing a lot of fans. So those are the two things I look at in that section. The last section that I wanted to go over is the reach section. And reach is important, but again, I don't stress about this too much. I want to make sure that we're growing, so you can actually click on the little side and it will tell you how you're doing this period versus last period. So I want to make sure that we're doing better. if you ever do paid ads, you will see that paid influences organic to have more reach. So you will see more reach in the times that you are running ads. So that's just something that we've talked about before. Facebook is a business. They need to make money so that you're going to get a little bit of a boost in your organic content as you are paying for ads elsewhere. So those are the things that I look at in Facebook Insights. Like I said, don't get yourself bogged down in the data. Just really understand, you know, what are your goals and is your content taking you to those goals? And if you're creating engaging and valuable content for your audience, you're going to be okay. You're going to be able to do it. Just, you know, continually to look at it so you have a good idea of where you want to be moving forward, and take advantage of things like knowing what days and times your audience are on to help you fight that algorithm, because we are all working against that. Now, I do have a link up in this, the description of this post to a blog post where we talk about all of this. There is also a free download. It defines what reach means. It defines what engagement means. There's a formula in there that you can calculate what your reach and what your engagement is. We talk about the averages there. So the average reach of a Facebook page is only 8 to 9%. So when you look at your numbers, we have a nice little easy, you don't have to be a math whiz, I'm not. There's an easy formula. You can go in there and calculate what your reach is from your page. It's very simple. And then there's an engagement rate formula in there as well. Typical Facebook engagement rates are 1 to 5%. So only 1 to 5% of people are engaging with your content on Facebook. Now, that's an average. It's going to vary depending on the size of your page. We get upwards of 25 to 50% engagement on our page. So it really varies on the number. Like if you have like 100,000 fans, your engagement's gonna go down just because of the sheer number of people. Facebook can't necessarily serve it to all of those people at a time. So make sure you get that download as well. It just talks about a couple things and gives you those formulas to look at. We also, next Monday, we're starting a Facebook Parties Bootcamp. I was wrapping up some of the content today and I am so excited. It's gonna be really, really good. It's gonna be awesome, you guys. So make sure if you haven't signed up for the Facebook Parties Bootcamp, I did include the link in the description of this post. So you can click on that and go ahead and register. It's free. It will be hosted in our Marketing for Mompreneurs private Facebook group, excuse me. You will get a email every day and a workbook every day. And then I'll be doing Facebook Lives every single day with a lesson and to take your questions about Facebook parties. So thank you guys so much. I am so sorry about the issues. I have noticed that Facebook is making a lot of updates and a few of my peers have had issues with Facebook Live as well. So I so apologize for that. Please, if you are watching this in the replay or you had tried to watch it during live and you weren't able to, I am always happy. I am always here to answer questions afterwards. So if I didn't get to your question because of the technical difficulties, I apologize. Please post them. I will get back to you. I hope you guys are having an amazing day. Make sure to read the blog post and to sign up for our Facebook Parties Bootcamp because I'm super duper excited about it. Share it with your team, give us a like, and we will see you guys again all soon. Thank you so much.